In the last lesson, we talked about black box testing or functional testing, which is the kind of testing that you perform when you just look at the description of the software. Today, we're going to cover white box testing, which is the kind of testing that we perform when we open up the box, when we look inside the program, and we actually test it based on its code. And there is one basic assumption behind the idea of white box testing, which is a very intuitive one. And the assumption is that executing the faulty statement is a necessary condition for revealing a fault. In other words, if there is a bug in the program, there is no way we're going to be able to find this bug or this fault if we don't execute the statement that contains it, which makes a lot of sense. As we did for black box testing, we're going to start by summarizing what are the main advantages of white box testing. The main advantage is that it's based on the code. And as such, the quality of white box testing can be measured objectively. And what I mean here by objectively is that if you think about black box testing, in many cases, there were subjective decisions that had to be made in order to define tests in a black box fashion. In the case of white box testing, because everything is based on the code, we don't have to make such subjective decisions. And similarly, because white box testing is based on the code, it can be measured automatically. So we can build tools, and actually there are tools, and there's plenty of tools, that can be measured the level of white box testing achieved in a fully automated way. And we're going to see some of them in the course of the class. Another advantage of white box testing is that it can be used to compare tests with. So if you have two alternative sets of tests that you can use to assess the quality of your software, white box testing techniques can tell you which one of these two test suites is likely to be more effective in testing your code. And finally, white box testing allows for covering the coded behavior of the software. What that means is that if there is some mistake in the code that is not obvious by looking at the specification of the code, white box testing might be able to catch it because it tries to exercise the code. There's many different kinds of white box testing. There are control flow-based techniques, data flow-based techniques, and fault-based techniques. And for each one of these family of techniques, there are many variations. So this field is very, very broad. In this lesson, we will talk about white box testing by focusing mainly on control flow-based testing techniques.